Today I'll be using the oldest tool I have in my collection. Well over a century ago, these logging tongs were hand-forged by a blacksmith. Every component, even the pins, were fashioned together by fire, anvil, and hammer. I purchased them a couple years ago from an antique dealer. For decades, they hung on a wall, treated not as a tool, but viewed as a decoration. Not to say that a tool can't be admired. In fact, I'm glad that someone thought well enough of these tongs to preserve them from the scrap heap. All I'm saying is that although some tools look nice hanging from a wall, it's even nicer being able to take them down again. I will select two logs from this stacked and frozen pile of poplars to process into lumber. Lumber which I will use to build a large sledge to haul with my snowmobile.
Back here now.
couple years ago, I built myself a dog sled style sledge, which I've been using to haul passengers and cargo through the bush. It has worked well for me, but I'm getting to the point where I could use a larger sled with a larger capacity for hauling cargo.
About doing maybe 3 or 4 inches of overhang, not much.
No, okay. Yeah, three, three is probably good.
This is three. Yeah, okay, I'll do three. So this will be the end of the ski here.
Thank you.
That should be enough.
Yeah, it looks great.
We cut the runners to a depth of 9 inches, which will help the sledge glide over the snow rather than through it, depending on how deep the powder is and how packed the trails are.
My drill's,
oh, it's in the cart, isn't it? May need to cut a bit more out of this one, the first thing.
And it, I'll take a saw and cut this proper
exact
middle, but that's, it's 39 inches. When we're cutting with the chainsaw.
Yeah.
Then you cut right on the line for the chainsaw too.
Good. Nice. There.
Yep. Oh, you need to get over the bunk. Okay. Tilt it down. Thank you.
I purchased a couple downhill skis from my local thrift store, $15 for the pair, which I will be attaching to the bottom of the runners.
That's the two you pulled off.
Yep.
Can do. Some of them have a little bit of a split if you want to cut as much of that off as possible.
Sure.
There.
that's nice.
For the hitch, a couple scrap metal rails worked perfectly. Now that the sledge base has been built, I can easily configure it to suit whatever job I'll be using it for this winter. For example, I can put rails on the side for hauling cedar posts or firewood blocks, or I can even build it into a little snowmobile camper for my overnight excursions into the bush. With the completion of the new sledge, I'm officially ready for winter. Bring on the snow. Until next time, my friends.